Today we are going to see how to make semiya halwa. It's an easy sweet which can be made in 10-15 minutes. The ingredients required are quite simple. Semiya, 1 cup, or it's also called as vermicelli. I have taken the unroasted version of it. You can get the roasted version of vermicelli as well. If it is not roasted, you have to roast it in ghee for this sweet. 1.5 teaspoon of raisins, 1.5 teaspoon of cashew, 1.5 teaspoon of badam. We are going to slice the badam into thin flakes. This is food color, orangish red. I have used a pinch of it. You can add saffron for taste. 5 teaspoons of ghee and sugar is 3/4 cup. If you are a sweet lover, please add another 1/4 cup. Water is 2 cups of the quantity of the semiya. Water measurement is very much important in upmas as well as in sweets. Heat a pan. Add a teaspoon of ghee to it and we are going to roast the nuts. First we are going to put badam flakes and then cashews. We are going to wait till these turn into golden color. Because these two take a bit longer than raisins, so first adding badam. And then cashews. Don't leave this and go away because they get fried very easily. They might be burnt. Put it in medium flame. Once they change the color, that heat a pan, add ghee to it. Add sliced almonds, cashews and raisins. Put it in medium flame and just be near the stove. Don't go away and roast the dry fruits. They get burnt very easily. We have to add raisins in the last because they are roasted very fastly. When they have turned into light color, right? Light golden color, that's when I have added the raisins. Roast it really well. And then after roasting them, we are going to set it aside. Heat a pan, add ghee to it, the remaining ghee, and nicely roast the semiya. Mine is an unroasted version of semiya, so I'm going to roast it for a little longer time. If yours is a roasted version, then you need not roast it for longer time. Now, if you look there, it has roasted. We are going to set the semiya aside and then heat the pan and boil exactly 2 cups of water till it evaporates. The little water starts to evaporate, that's when we'll add the semiya. Measurements are very important here. When the water starts to evaporate, add the semiya and now we are going to cook the semiya till it softens and no water is left in the semiya. Soft texture should come. This is another tip for upma also. If you cook semiya like this and garnish it, we hold the semiya in our hand and then if you just press it, you can find out whether it has softened or not. The lid is put to expedite the process of cooking. It cooks faster, so I have covered it with a lid. Now add sugar to it. When sugar is added, what happens is it oozes out water. When it oozes out water, it again dilutes. So you have to cook it again for 5 minutes. If you see watery consistency has come,